Randy?
Yeah.
What's happening? Jay, nice to meet you. Tell me about this truck.
This is my third Ram. I've always been very happy with them. Never had any problems until my check engine light came on. Did a little self-troubleshooting with the fault codes and found out that my grid heater is going bad. And before it drops into my number six cylinder and damages my piston or my valves, I thought I'd take some action. Did some troubleshooting on what it could be, and they said check the wire harness, and if the nut's loose, then you've got a problem, a major problem. And instead of taking it to the dealership and having them do whatever they do and replacing it with the same part, I thought I'd go with Banks because they claim that it's a fix for the problem. And why not fix it right for about the same money that the dealership would charge me? So here we are.
And gain some performance while you're at it.
Yeah, the truck performs great anyway. But if I can get a little bit more airflow to my engine and help combust that diesel fuel a little bit more, why not? A stock engine, a 2017 Ram 3500 with the 6.7 Cummins in it. And this just happens to be one of the problems that that the engineers think isn't worth fixing.
So when did you decide to give it the jiggle test?
As soon as possible. As soon as the fault code showed that it was the heater grid, then they gave me a list. You know, I'm not a big fan of people troubleshooting my work by going on the internet, but sometimes the internet helps. And they gave me a list of things it could be, and they said start here. And the start here was the jiggle test, and it just happened to be the problem.
This is the 12-volt lead that comes directly from the battery and goes to the top of the grid heater.
It says that it's 12 volts, but the amount of current going through there is enough to shear a bolt. This is the bolt here, and if there's any play, your bolt is starting to fry. But you can see that.
That sucker's moving.
Yeah, halfway, if not more, through this bolt.
This problem was thought for a long time to be isolated to guys who are using their grid heater all the time.
Oh, well,
you're living in Southern California. Here's the sky. There's the mountains over there. The beach is not too far from here. It's pretty temperate. So this grid heater in your truck is probably not seeing a whole lot of use, and yet it's still happening.
No, this is a perfect example of if you think it can't happen to you, no matter where you live, that's not true. Next step is to close it up, not start it, get it over to Banks and have them fix this problem for good. They're local. I was very lucky they're local here in Southern California. And I'm going to have the guys button this up so that I never have this problem again. And hopefully they'll improve my gas mileage or my horsepower or, you know, any kind of added bonus is fine with me. The guys over at Banks have been nice enough to get my truck in quicker than the dealership. Couldn't be happier with the service and the response and the customer service that they've given me.
So the next time we see your Ram, it'll be on the back of a flatbed headed to our office. All right, Robert, let's give this a wiggle. Holy mackerel. All right, let's see what's going on under there. Oh my Lord. Robert, bring it over here. So what happened, Robert, is that the lead that energizes the grid heater right here, it melted, and this piece sticking up, let me go from the top here, this piece that I'm putting my finger on, that melted and just started falling down like a stalactite from a cave. Because this is upside down, of course, right now. This bolt just, look at that. Look at that. And then you can see this piece. Oh, I just broke it off. Where'd it go? I just flung it. Look at that. It was ready to fall off any day now. Oh, that could have been catastrophic. In a 2017 Ram, this guy right here, with just over 100,000 miles on it. Wow. Dang, talking about dodging a bullet. Now, I'm not saying that the engine compartment on a new Ram is ugly, but I am saying the Monster Ram definitely dresses it up a bit. And no more grid heater. We will soon have a vertical coil style heater sitting where this socket wrench is passing through. All right, he's here. What did you think of this thing?
It's exactly like I thought it was gonna look. That's what they all look like when they're about to fail or after they have failed. Yep, I'm not surprised. The Jiggle Test proved that that's what it was gonna look like, and the mechanic proved it.